The most iconic planet in our solar system is losing the very thing that draws the human gaze its way. Scientists from NASA have confirmed that our beloved Saturn is losing its rings at an alarming rate. Saturn is the sixth planet from the Sun and the second largest in the solar system after Jupiter. It is a gas giant. It is 9 times larger than our Earth but has only 1/8 the average density of Earth. That means, in theory, Saturn can float on water. In 1610, the year after Galileo turned a telescope to the sky, he became the first person to observe Saturn's rings. Though he could not see them well enough to discern their true nature. In 1655, Christian Huygens was the first person to describe them as a disk surrounding Saturn. The rings extend from 6600 to 121,000 kilometers outward from Saturn's equator and average approximately 20 meters in thickness. Saturn has several rings and gaps between them. These gaps are called divisions. Saturn's rings are mostly chunks of water ice ranging in size from microscopic dust grains to boulders of several meters in diameter. Ring particles are caught in a balancing act between the pull of Saturn's gravity and the centrifugal force due to their orbital velocity. Astronomers have long wondered about the origins of Saturn's rings. Some believed they appeared when the planet first pulled itself together about 4.5 billion years ago. Others thought they were formed by colliding moons, asteroids, comets, or even the remainders of dwarf planets between 10 million and 100 million years ago. Data from Cassini spacecraft sent by NASA in 1997 suggests the second hypothesis. Most of Saturn's rings lie within what's known as the Roche limit. It is the distance a satellite can orbit a large object without the planet's tidal force overpowering the object's own gravity and tearing it apart. Saturnian's rings that lie outside the Roche limit stay together because the gravitational influence of other satellites, such as moons. If the rings had stayed intact so far, it seemed unlikely that they would suddenly start disintegrating. That's right, Saturn is losing its rings, and it is happening very fast, much faster than scientists had previously thought. Right now, it's raining 10,000 kilograms of ring rain on Saturn per second, fast enough to fill an Olympic-sized pool in half an hour. This rain is actually the disintegrated remnants of Saturn's rings. Now we have known about ring rain since 1980s when NASA's Voyager mission first noticed mysterious dark bands that turned out to be ring rain caught in Saturn's magnetic fields. Back then, researchers estimated the rings would totally drain in 300 million years. But to understand it deeply, Cassini spacecraft was sent and from its data, the estimated lifespan was reduced to 100 million years. The main reason behind the ring rain is the ionization of particles. Tiny particles can get electrically charged by ultraviolet light from the sun or by plasma clouds emanating from micrometeoroid bombardment of the rings. When this happens, the particles can feel the pull of Saturn's magnetic field. The magnetic field curves inward toward the planet at Saturn's rings. This process is going on continuously and rapidly. So it is a matter of time when our beloved Saturn will lose its magnificence. Hope you liked this video. Please like, share, and comment. And to see such videos in future, please subscribe.